Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. So we've got another generative AI video today. So it's going to be for a Midjourney clone, or basically a free Midjourney clone. So you can use this version without having to pay anything. So it works really good. It follows a very similar process to Midjourney. You might have already heard of it, but probably not. So we'll jump straight into it. It's called BlueWillow, and it's basically runs exactly the same as Midjourney. It's via Discord as well. So I'll leave a link in the description to get into the Discord channel. So this is the website here. Basically just click join the free beta. It'll link you across to Discord. So just jump through the usual hoops and you are set. So we'll just close the window. And this one here, we'll come back to ChatGPT in a second because I want to show you something else pretty cool. Okay, so we'll jump over to the Discord channel. There's a couple of things to take note of here. Depending on when you get in, this section might look a little bit different. And if you don't see the rookie channels, which we're going to need, you need to click the little icon up here, the BlueWillow verified tick. Then go down and go show all channels. So make sure that's ticked and it will bring up all the rookie channels on the side here, which is what we need to use to generate content. So we're going to jump into rookie 67. And just like Midjourney, this is where all of our images get created. So we'll go to the bottom, we'll go slash imagine space. And here's where we can enter our prompt. So this is where I'm going to be using ChatGPT. So we're going to minimize Discord and go over to ChatGPT. And here is where we're going to do something pretty cool. So we're going to get ChatGPT to write us some prompts. So we're going to do something like this. So this is a prompt that works really well, and ChatGPT will fill in the blanks. So we're going to go an image of, adjective, subject, doing action, backlighting, some more stuff here. So you can fill in whatever you want for these. This is one that works really well, trending on ArtStation. It seems to pick up some of the more interesting stuff. Then next we have three different variables. So science fiction movie 1, science fiction movie 2, and science fiction movie 3. Then in the theme of, let's go random, trending topic. So what we've done here basically is by using these brackets, ChatGPT will know to fill it in with any adjective, any subject, any action, backlighting. It'll change it to a few different things. You'll see in a second. And then it'll fill in the last three ones here with random movies. So we could get three different movies from the sci-fi genre, and the same for random topics. So we're going to just take that out for a second, and we're going to type, this is a template for Midjourney prompts. It will explain the prompt a little bit. Okay, depending on what you type, it's going to carry on a little bit. So we're going to go and tell it to create 5 different prompts. You can do as many as you want, but I want to start with 5. So use this template to, let's say, write 5 different prompts for Midjourney. You can say BlueWillow, but it seems to recognize Midjourney better. So just stick with Midjourney and you can prompt it into BlueWillow. So we've got 5 pretty cool different prompts here, really different ones. As you can see, it's filled in the sections we need it to. So we've got our different movies here. We will grab this bottom one. So just grab it, copy and paste, back over to Discord, and we will put in our prompt and press enter. So this is the annoying part, because you've got to skip ahead in the public channels. So this is our result. We'll just miss going over where it actually accepted it because I don't want to find it. So that's our prompt there. We can expand it to see our images. They're actually pretty good. As with Midjourney, we've got our usual options here. So we can upscale 1, 2, 3, or 4. So 1, 2, 3, or 4. And we can make a new variant on these three options. Otherwise, we can refresh. So we will do one more attempt. And I think you've got the gist of it after that. Let's grab this one here, go back over to Discord slash imagine space and paste in our next prompt. I'll jump right down to the bottom so we can try to catch it this time, maybe. Press enter. Okay, so that's our prompt getting initiated. Now we just gotta keep flicking forward until we can see it again. Something else interesting about BlueWillow is it doesn't have as many restrictions as Midjourney, so you can do some more interesting stuff and not get censored or blocked or whatever usually happens. So there we go. There's our new content. And again, we can go through the usual process. Okay, so the next most important thing to take into account here is the prompting guide and variables or parameters. So if you jump back over to the BlueWillow website, I'll leave a link in the description for this as well, is these are the parameters you can use for adjusting stuff inside your image. So flick through here, there's a different set of parameters for each. So you can just go imagine painting of a cute cat and then drop in your parameters to get really specific information. So they're all listed here. All you got to do is add them to your prompt, just like the examples here, and you're good to go. There's plenty of different variables, so go through and you can adjust whatever you want. Outside of that, you can pretty much go crazy with Blue Willow. So experiment, see what you come up with. And as always, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in another video. Cheers, everyone.